So, I'm Ramon Torrent. I'm a retired professor at the University of Barcelona of Political Economy and International Economic Law. But what's more important for my presentation today is that for 10 years I was a director of external relations in the legal service of the Council of the European Union in Brussels. So I had the opportunity, for good or for bad, to live from the inside and to know the working of the European Union. And this is very relevant for my short presentation today. I'm the scientific coordinator of EULAC Focus and the one who has coordinated the plan of action, whose short version I have just sent to all of you. And please, Cecilia, forward it to those who were not in my mailing, because this will be what I will be presenting now. I will concentrate on 3 points. The first is a general presentation of EULAC focus approach to the analysis of EU, Latin American, and Caribbean relations. The second is a reference to the analytical framework of regional integration that we have used. And the third is a more concrete reference to science diploma. I'll begin with the general approach. And I'll begin as I tried to explain it in the last 2 years. I will begin asking you, in particular those of you who have not followed from inside the implementation of the project, the following question. The call in which framework we were selected had as title the cultural, scientific, and social dimension of EU, Latin American, and Caribbean relations. And we simply took the title and put giving focus to before it. In plain terms, please do not talk so much and do a bit more. But I will concentrate in the title of the call. And I ask people, the question I'm asking all of you, in particular those not participating in the project, is whether you understand the title, the cultural, scientific, and social dimensions of EU, Latin American, and Caribbean relations. And probably all of you will give the same answer I have always been given, which is yes, it is a broad topic, but we understand it. And then my answer is, I'm sorry, I fear you don't understand it. Why? Because probably you take the title at face value, and you imagine that there is something named EU, Latin American and Caribbean LAC, that is to say, relations. And this something has three parts or aspects or dimensions: culture, science, and social policies. And we study these three parts, or we qualify the main topic of EULAC relations with these three specific contexts. And probably you understand the title like this. And this is what justifies me to say that you don't understand the title. Why? Because in this title, it is assumed that there is something named EU LAC relations. We all know that LAC is what it is, and LAC is lacking a sort of regional personality. LAC is the countries of Latin American and Caribbean. For example, Brazil. This is clear. But if you turn to the European Union, the situation is different. The European Union does exist. So we have to understand what the European Union is. And here the surprise comes, because the European Union is a very strange entity, a legal, political, institutional entity, whose main characteristic is that it does not have sovereignty in singular. It does not have competence in singular, but it only has competences in plural. And then comes the decisive question. Does the European Union has a competence to conduct external relations with Brazil and Argentina and Colombia and Guatemala and Jamaica, as all these countries have? And please be seated now, because the answer is very clear. No. No. If you look at the competences conferred by the treaties to the European Union, you don't find a competence on external relations as Brazil or Guatemala can have. The competence on foreign relations given by the Treaty of European Union to the European Union is a competence that only allows the European Union to talk, but prohibits, look at the word, prohibits the European Union from doing nothing on the basis of this competence. If the European Union wants to do something, has to turn to the 28 specific competences attributed to her or to it by the Treaty on the Functioning of the European Union, the former Treaty of the European Community. These competences, not one of them is on external relations, and all are specific competences on internal policies. But these internal policies, in principle, are competences for us Europeans, not for you, Latin American, are competences on what happens between the member states of the European Union, not about what happens between the European Union and Brazil or Guatemala or Jamaica. So when one has understood this and has really digested and metabolized it, understands the problem. And the problem is that you have to reverse, completely reverse, the title of the code. Instead of discussing the cultural, scientific, and social dimension, or something that does not exist, which is EULAC foreign relations, you have to look at what exists. And what exists are the internal, I underline internal, cultural, scientific, and social dimensions, social policies of the European Union. And the challenge is how to give some Latin American and Caribbean dimension to these internal policies. Challenge very difficult to face, because one can imagine that to give Latin American and Caribbean dimension to policies thought only for Europeans is very difficult. So I put an end to this first part of my explanation. The title should be changed to how to give a LAC dimension to internal EU policies in the cultural, scientific, and social areas. And put the question like this, or you know that the answer is very difficult. It is very difficult to really give a large dimension to internal EU policies meant for internal EU action addressed to EU citizens and economic operators. But this is the only way to really think about what the European Union can do. Literature on EU-like relations has been full of words about what the European Union should do, as if the European Union was the United States or Japan or China. But the European Union is what I have tried to explain to you. So we must turn modestly, not what to the European Union should do, but to what the European Union can do. And what the European Union can do in the cultural, scientific, and social area with Latin America and the Caribbean is very little. And we need a lot of knowledge and a lot of imagination to find a way of putting Latin America and the Caribbean within internal EU policy. The second point of my presentation is about the analytical framework we use. It is an analytical framework that I designed in the framework of a very ambitious and nice project by the Inter-American Development Bank in 2002 and 2003 on regional integration. And it is an analytical framework, very common sense, that simply distinguishes the preconditions, because preconditions are not the same in different geographical settings and are not the same in different historical moments. And you cannot intend to do something if preconditions are not adequate. Second, it distinguishes objectives, because in order to conduct international relations, you must know the objectives. And the objectives is not a long list of them. When you have a long list of objectives, you are pretty sure that you will not achieve or reach any one of them. Objectives must be a few and adequately articulated between the foremost and all-important political objectives and a small set of intermediate ones, allowing you to advance towards the overall one. Then you distinguish the instruments, because there are four instruments that are different. Legal rules that create obligations, public activities, public policies implemented using money, let's say, then redistribution to the budget, and then diplomatic instruments. All these instruments are different, but one must know what one is doing. One must know that diplomatic instruments make sense, but essentially diplomatic instruments are there to talk and to write, not to do or to produce rules. So they are useful, but they are very limited in scope. For example, if you look at the joint initiative on research and innovation between the European Union and Latin America, you must know that this is simply a diplomatic instrument. So when you participate in this joint initiative and you participate there as a diplomat, please, you must be aware that there is not a euro to be spent on there. Because a euro to be spent is a public activity. And the public activities the European Union can apply are internal public activities, as I have explained in the first point. So, talking in the framework of the Joint Initiative on Research and Innovation can be useful, because better to be talking than to be fighting. But be aware of the limitations. And when you talk about social policy of the European Union, be aware that internally, this is not spending money on poverty, but producing legal rules for migrant workers. Be aware that in terms of social policy, the European Union nearly does not spend a euro, because social policies, as what you in Brazil would say, social policies, spending money in what in the past was Bolsa Familia, or now can be another thing. This is a discussion that the European Union cannot have. It is member states that do or don't do the equivalent to this policy. And finally, reference in the analytical framework to the dimensions. Regional integration, international relations are not unidimensional, move along different dimensions and can go forward in one and backwards in one. If you hear carefully at the sentence of three lines that I will improvise now, you'll see the logic of these four dimensions. The European Union in the last 30 years, based on its high capacity of adaptation, this is one dimension, has gained an enormous amount of content. Effective content is another dimension, but has lost a lot of strength. This is pretty clear, and strength is a third dimension, and has not advanced so much as we were promised in the external dimension. So, if one has to assess European integration, one must conclude that it has advanced in some directions, maybe and essentially in content, but it has gone backwards in other dimensions, obviously in that of strength, and it has not advanced so much as we were promised in terms of external dimension. Whether this is overall positive or not, anyone can judge. But what one cannot do analytically or in terms of policy making is to say, we have advanced in one direction. That's it. No. You have to consider the four dimensions at the same time. And this is also the analytical framework you use in OLACFO. And finally, in the plan of action, you will find in two places a clear reference to science diplomacy, and in particular to the S4, D4C project. One is in the one of the strategies we propose, the strategy of the specifically the scientific area. I think that it is in part two, the point 2.5 or 2.6. And finally, in part three, when we present the transformation of the OLAC focus project into an OLAC focus permanent informal but permanent network, there you will also see that we will try to fit EULAC focused results into the science diplomacy project that you, Elke, are leading from the CSI in Wien. That's all on my side. Now I have already talked too much. I will give the floor for the rest of the meeting to all of you. It has been a pleasure and an honor being able to introduce EULAC Focus and EULAC Focus Plan of Action to all of you. Anyway, I have sent the nearly final version of the deliverable 6-4 with the plan of action to all of you. If someone has not received it, please, Cecilia, forward it to all of them. Thank you very much. Bye.